Stop me when you know what I'm talking about. Born in the Sudan, he moved to Cairo, to Paris, and then to London, where he became immensely popular when it was announced in 1882. Yeah.
There's an elephant in the room.
Why is that?
Whoever he is, he's an elephant.
He's right! Very good.
Was he Jumbo? Was he Jumbo?
He was Jumbo the elephant. Very good. Brilliant. Well done. He was the most famous animal in the world, and he gave his name to anything big. Jumbo jets are named after Jumbo the elephant. It was simply his name. He was such an enormous elephant. Look at the size of that elephant. That is an enormous...
That's a big elephant.
That is one big elephant.
He's like the size of an elephant, isn't
he? He is, basically he is. London Zoo gave a rhino to Paris Zoo and got Jumbo in return, which was a marvellous, marvellous bargain because he became incredibly popular. But then... an American paid $10,000 for Jumbo to take him to America. Who would that American have been?
P.T. Barnum, I should imagine.
Phineas T. Barnum. Who else? Exactly.
And then he died and he had him stuffed and people still paid to go and see him.
You're absolutely right. There were riots in England, virtually. There were debates in Parliament. People threatened to kill Barnum and even threatened to kill Jumbo, saying that Jumbo dead was better than Jumbo exported. This is a rather bizarre way of looking at it.
That's a hell of a march to go on, isn't it? Jumbo, kill Jumbo!
Kill Jumbo.
What do we want? Dead Jumbo!
But as I say, $10,000 was a lot of money, but when Barnum got into America, in 3 days he made $30,000 out of him. By the end, he had made $1.5 million in only 3 years from this. Jumbo mania was even bigger in America. They went crazy for this animal. They'd pay anything to see it. But as you say, it was actually in Ontario. He'd done his circus, which was called... what was the name of his circus? The
greatest show
on earth. Oh, yeah, the greatest show on earth. And he had 29 elephants had been safely put into their freight cars, and he had two left. His smallest elephant, who was called Tom Thumb, and his biggest, obviously, Jumbo. And an unscheduled train came, and poor Jumbo got the full force. 100 places his skull was broken in. It took 126 men to lift him off the track. He was cradled in the arms of his trainer, Mr. Scott, and he died.
I don't want him!
So Barnum's got the little elephant, he's got the great big one. If he gets elephants of decreasing size, he can hollow them out and have, like, Russian elephant bowls.
But you're right also about the stuffing. A taxidermist and a team of six butchers then got to work on emptying poor Jumbo of his insides and stuffing him with whatever they stuffed them with. And he was moved to Tufts University, where he was the mascot for until 1975, and he was destroyed in a fire. But there, and that's why we get jumbo-sized things. That's why we use the word jumbo to mean big.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.